think drugs have done some good things for us. I really do. And if you don't believe drugs have done good things for us, do me a favor. Go home tonight, take all your albums, all your tapes, and all your CDs and burn them. Because you know what? The musicians who made all that great music that's enhanced your lives throughout the years? Real fucking high on drugs.
Hypocrisy is a boil. Lancing a boil is never pleasant.
Okay, it's dog registration time. 2016. It's been a bonny year so far. So, I decided, I did all the emailing shit last year. I put everything in writing, so I don't need to continue that further. But really, because I'm feeling slightly mischievous, I thought I'd give up the council a call and just tell them from a third person's perspective, speaking of my wife's dog. So, yeah, we'll see where the conversation goes. 836 8000. Try them later.
2. For rubbish, recycling and inorganic services, please press 3. For all other inquiries, please hold.
It's holding.
Thank you for your patience. We will be with you as soon as possible.
Fuck, I hope so. Sun's setting. Sorry, Annil?
Yes?
Yes, hi, how are you?
Good, thank you, how are you?
Not too bad. I'm hoping you can direct me in the right place and answer a few general inquiries, if you could, please.
Yes, certainly.
My wife and I have been having an ongoing dispute now for a few years over dog registration. She's, you know, lives in a bit of fear and is worried about getting fined or other problems, and myself, not so much. What I've done over the last few years is each time dog registrations come round, I've made contact with the council and given an offer to happily register, you know, our dog if the council could provide the obligation for me to do so. Now I've spoken to Lee Exler and another gentleman over the time who are senior dog control officers and stuff, and they've been unable to provide it. So I mean, I don't do things unless there's an obligation to, and the council's been unable to at the moment. Now, my wife's argument is that it's really her dog, even though I paid for it, and that if she doesn't register it, then she's going to accrue a cost. And I've found out in previous years that it's apparently only if there's a complaint or something made in regards to a wandering dog or something that the council would be involved anyway. You know, like they just can't come wandering onto the property willy-nilly and come looking.
Well, is that dog currently registered?
No, hasn't been for years. And see, which of course brings another question to be that, to me, if something was, a debt was owed, then it would accrue over a period of years. And for the last few years, it doesn't seem to be that we haven't accrued any extra costs for not registering it, and it hasn't continued on concurrently throughout the years, so...
It doesn't happen like that, sir.
Well, so you can skip a year and not worry about it?
Well, if you get caught, you get entrenched.
Well, how would you get caught, though?
Don't know. Again, you
So a complaint... My point is, a complaint would have to be made for them to investigate in the first place, correct?
That's right.
And if the dog doesn't wander off the property, there's no...
But it's a legal obligation on the part of the dog owner to...
Exactly, exactly. And I understand the difference between a dog owner and a person and myself, a man. Now, my argument is that the dog is my property. I bought it, I do the upkeep, I look after it, it's exclusive to me. And for me to register that with a corporation such as the council, there should be an obligation to do so. Now, if I'm acting as a person within a society of New Zealand through my, you know, persona, be it a natural person, legal person, whatever, I'm still representing myself, whereas I just live in the present as a man. So my argument is that if I don't use my persona to register my property, and as far as I know, there's no obligation for me to do so as a man. So who says that I have to register anything of mine to anybody else? Because it's mine.
If it's your property, you should have some proof that you own.
Well, I can prove. I can prove ownership of the animal because I bought it. And it would be for the council to prove they have some sort of tangible asset in my property for them to make demands upon me. They don't have authority over me.
Where are we going with this?
Well, my argument is that she's concerned that she's going to incur fees, and yet over the past few years...
No, that's not how it happens now.
Well, then how does it happen? Can you explain it to me?
Well, it's your legal obligation. Every year you need to pay a dog registration. It's your legal obligation every year you need to pay a dog registration, yes? It's your legal obligation every year you need to pay a dog registration, yes? It's your legal obligation every year you need to pay a dog registration. You're saying the dog's not registered at all?
No, it hasn't been. Not for years.
It's an unregistered dog.
No, it's my property. It's my property, sir.
Let me finish, sir. Sure. And if you've escaped the paying the fee...
Well, I'm not escaping anything.
Then,
I mean, see, you've got to understand, I'm not trying to avoid or escape anything. I'm staying in honour the entire way, and I've given the council a conditional acceptance that I would be happy to register my property as a dog should the council be able to provide me the obligation that myself, a man, has to do so. And then it would be for the council to provide...
It's a private
matter. Well, it is a private matter, exactly. The council is a private corporation. They have no authority over me whatsoever. It's a civil matter. The government has no authority over myself as a man.
By the Dog Control Act, you have to have the dog registered.
Okay, now, and I've been through this with Lee Exler, and he's told me that the Dog Control Act, that any person or a dog owner, now, I asked him to please define what he meant by person, because I'm aware, through legal counsel, that a person can be defined as five different things, none of which is myself a man. I'm a man. Would you agree to that? I sound like a man to you? You sound like a man to me. You don't sound like a person, because I know that a person has been screwed into all of these other different types of interpretations legally. Now, as a man, I have the right, unalienable and natural, to do whatever I wish. I'm not talking about a legal obligation. I'm staying in honour as a lawful man.
I mean, let's put it in another context here, sir.
Sure.
Dog is the property of the dog owner. House is the property of the house owner.
No, the dog is mine.
I'm saying something here, sir.
Okay.
Dog is the property of the owner.
Okay.
The dog is considered the property of the owner. Okay, it is a property.
Sure. So well, it's a family member to me. I class that... Sure.
So is a car, so is it a house, so you pay rates for your house. It's legally binding.
I pay my rates because I use the services.
No, you have to register your car every year.
Well, that's debatable, actually, because I'm having the same issues with the New Zealand Land Transport Agency. What? I'm asking them...
It's a legal obligation to...
Again, it's a legal obligation, but the legal does not override my lawful right to do as I wish in the first place, and I have a lawful right to travel.
It is a lawful right to meet with your legal obligations,
sir. No, sorry, see, that's the difference.
Pay your taxes.
Can you? Oh, I don't have to pay my taxes. That's the thing.
Okay,
you
okay,
voluntarily declare your income. I'm just trying to find out. You're trying to explain to me that as a dog owner, so therefore you're telling me if I have to act as that capacity. I'm saying I'm not lowering myself to that capacity. I'm equal.
Okay, that's a matter of semantics.
It is not a semantical argument. It is a legal argument.
No, I'm not here to argue with you, sir.
Well, argue means to clarify, sir. I'm only asking for clarification.
No. I've already clarified. It's a very simple thing. You own a dog, it's your obligation to register it.
Well, I look after a member of my family. I don't really own it. It cost me $1,000 to have her freed, but she's a member of our family, just as much as any of my other children are.
That's your choice.
Exactly.
If you want to...
That's how I define her, because she is mine.
You are aware of what the law states.
But the law doesn't state that. The law tries to put it into classifications and characterizations and capacities.
Do you want to put it, sir.
Exactly.
Semantics.
It's wordplay, and that's how it's tried to be governed in the first place. I'm just sticking to simple logic. I'm a man equal to any other.
What service do you want from me today, sir?
I was asking for clarification as to whether or not my wife is going to get any sort of infringement or fine if we don't register the dog yet again for another year.
If found out, you will be infringed.
If found out, and how would I be found? How would I be found out if there isn't a complaint made?
I can't answer that question again.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Now, if I've given the council a removal of implied right of access in writing over the last few years, the council has been notified. Therefore, it's been put in writing, and once expressed, there's no more implication. So therefore, if I've expressed that they have no right of access to the property, they can't come on.
What you're telling me is that you don't want to register your dog. That's your choice.
No, I'm saying I don't have to register my dog. I'm saying I don't have to register my dog, and it's for the council to prove the obligation for me to do so. Do you understand that?
That's fine, but...
The council can't prove it. They can't make me do something. It's an act, yes. It's a legislative rule of a society. It's an enactment. It's not law.
It's a law.
It's not. It's an enactment. An enactment is a legislative rule of society given the force of law. How can it be given the force of itself?
Whatever you think is suitable for you, fine.
Exactly. And I wish you good day, sir. Thank you very much for taking the time to help me and try and clear it up.
My pleasure.
You have a great day.
You too, thank you.
Be well.
Bye.
What a nice gentleman. He got what I was saying. But as far as myself being a dog owner, well, I don't class myself as a dog owner. She might be a dog just as much as I might be classed as a Homo sapien. But she's still a member of the family. If she ran off tomorrow, there ain't much I can do about it. Like, if one of my children ran off tomorrow, there ain't much I can do about it. They're going to do what they're going to do. I don't control her actions. She never wanders. She likes it here, funnily enough. So, the whole theory that unless I'm found out, I'm not trying to evade anything. I'm giving a conditional acceptance for the council to please provide me evidence that I have to. All the council have ever spouted off to me are sections of the Dog Control Act, which they can't legally even do because they're not legally trained to even give me the correct legal interpretations of the Dog Control Act. If I'm going to speak Japanese, I should be fluent in the language. And if they're going to spout off legal acts or legislation, they should be fluent in understanding or the correct interpretations of the word from the author's perspective before spouting it off to me. But of course, they never give you legal advice because they're not trained to. They're just giving you their best guess, and they're leaving it up to the fear of the individual to cave in. You know, he understood where I was coming from. That's why he didn't get angry. That's why he said, you can think what you like, and I will. I have done, and I've proven it continually year after year. So, council have no implied right of access to the property. Yes, property, because we claim it to be ours. End of. And property is defined as that which is an individual, which is exclusive to any individual. The end point being within any society. So they would have to show me that I'm a member of their society first, before they can impose that on me. As far as I'm aware, I'm speaking English. To me, property means that's mine. It's no one else's. Fuck off. End of my subtle rant. Have a good day, people. Bye.